I review Citadel's contrast paint today on DungeonCraft. Welcome to DungeonCraft. I'm Professor Dungeon Master, and this channel is about playing the ultimate game of Dungeons & Dragons. You can level up your game by subscribing and click the bell icon for notifications, and you'll be on your way to adventure. So recently, Citadel Color, one of the most popular paint lines, it's a division of Games Workshop, came out with this product called Contrast Paint. The paint is a little bit thicker, and the color, the pigment, is a little bit deeper than what you get in a wash. So the idea is you just slap the contrast paint on the model right out of the bottle, and the raised areas will get tinted the lighter color, and the recesses will become darker. So recently, my buddy Adhesive Tom and I went to our local game shop, picked up two or three contrast paints, and took them to the New York City DungeonCraft studio to put them to the test. On the left is the Wizard from Cool Mini or Not's Massive Darkness board game. To the right is Galadon the Wizard by Reaper Bones, which I will paint twice. The idea is to use three techniques so we can compare the results. First, I'll do painting up, second, contrast paint, and third, the traditional base coat and shading. I mount the figures on soda caps with poster tack. I prime the models gray, then mist with Citadel's Corax White. This will create some nice shadows, but you always want to use contrast paints over a white primer. I start by doing the detail work like the belts as well as the flesh. Here I'm using Citadel's Cadian Flesh Tone for all the models. We completed all today's paintings with these number 8 round synthetic brushes we got from Hobby Lobby. I don't include a link below because we've never been able to find one, we always just find them in the store. We were introduced to these brushes by pro painter James Wappel. We recently caught up with James at Gen Con and he explains the value of painting with a cheap brush.
Hey guys, this is James Wappel, and you're going to be my cheap brush apostles. After you hear this little sermon here, say, why do you advocate the cheap brushes? Well, they tend to be more rugged. They actually tend to hold more paint. Those fancy sable brushes, they're designed to be very soft. A synthetic brush, cheaper brush, it's more rugged, it's going to hold more paint, and it takes the punishment. And as people know me, I can put glue in my brush, clean it in rubbing alcohol, and I'm painting again, freehand, eyeballs. People get really entertained when they get mad when I do this. Actually, they get more mad than entertained. It's because they're saying, I just paid $20 for a brush that I have to protect with every inch of my life. Or I could spend $5, get 10 brushes that will last me a long time, and oh, if they get super glue in them, no big deal. It's not a problem. Try out those cheap brushes, you may be surprised.
Thanks, James. I'm going to paint the Seamon Mini the way I normally do, with a technique called painting up. I start with a darker base, in this case, Citadel's Calidore Sky, and gradually add layers of lighter colors. As always, thin your paints to the consistency of skim milk so you don't obscure any of the details. For the next layer, I'm adding light blue to dark blue in equal amounts. I'm applying this to the wet model. This is called wet blending. And I'm just going to be applying it to the raised areas of the model. I repeat this step 4 to 5 times, each time adding more light blue to the mix, ending with a light blue mixed with white. The key is to consistently add flow improver to each layer to blend the paint properly. The effect will be a dramatic, almost airbrushed look that I personally like. I did the same thing to the darker leather as well, lightening it up over several layers. And this adds a sense of dynamism to an already dramatic looking figure. Here it is complete. And now for Citadel's Talisar Blue Contrast Paint. This is going on right from the bottle. I run the brush over the raised areas to sop up the extra paint. You want your highest areas to be the brightest. I'm using Snakebite Leather contrast paint on the hat band. So this is on the left with the contrast paint, and I am going to now wash this light blue, that's my base color, with this Drakenhof Nightshade by Citadel, which is a dark blue wash. So I'm here with the three models and Adhesive Tom. And to the left is the traditional way of painting with a lighter color and washing it with a wash. To the right is straight contrast paint straight out of the bottle. And to the far right is the technique painting up, where we start with a dark color and we gradually add a lighter color. Adhesive Tom, what is your erudite opinion?
I'd say this one is clearly the best one. The starting dark and painting up, going lighter as you go along, gives you the most realistic effect. Contrast paint is interesting. It would be good for a beginner. This one I think would look good, but for some reason it looks like the wash didn't take to the paint really well. I'm not sure why. It looked like it was almost repelled by the paint.
We could always wash it again after it's dry, it's still wet.
Otherwise,
we could try to darken it. All right, we have a couple other examples of the contrast paint. These stone pieces, and these were done with the Silicanum Gray. It's gray contrast paint. What do you make of these?
Those look fantastic. Absolutely great. There's one coat, one application, and it looks fantastic. You don't need to do anything else to it. Just seal it, and it's done. It really works great on stonework.
All right, this is, I painted a few figures for the game, what was it called, Horrified. And I used the contrast paint on this creature from the Black Lagoon. Actually, Mrs. Professor Dungeon Master painted it. And that was done with one coat of Dark Angel's Green. What's your verdict on this model?
This is fantastic. I mean, the contrast paint works really good on monsters. I mean, it's nice and dark exactly where you want it to be, in the folds of the flesh and the scales. It looks great. And light on the top, absolutely great. First-time painter and one-coat application, that's amazing.
So what's your verdict? What do you think? Are these paints...
They're definitely worth the money. And if you were a first-time painter or you're just getting into the hobby, I'd go the extra mile and spend the extra money on the contrast paints for sure.
Some work better than others. Like, I'm not a big fan of... Here, this is snakebite leather. I'm not a really big fan of that.
Oh, that's a contrast paint?
Yeah, that's a contrast paint. I'm not really a big fan of that color. I think the blue worked well, the gray worked well.
Gray worked fantastic.
I tend to agree with you. If you are a new person and you're painting, let's say, a lot of monsters all at once, then it's probably worth it. Like, if you're painting a ton of orcs, like we did that video a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
70 orcs in 70.
That contrast paint came in invaluable at that point, yeah.
Yeah, we could have made the orcs blue skin or green skin a lot faster. I think we did wash it with... I think we washed the skin for the green orcs. But I washed them twice. I used two different colored washes. Right, so you could do the contrast paint and just do it once.
Yeah, you'd save a lot of time.
And it would have saved a lot of time.
So here's a shot of the models from beginning to completion. Our final verdict on the paint we tried. The blue works very well. Not as good as painting up, but it's great for beginners. The gray worked really well. And the green is good for skin or metal, but not so much for cloth. I really did like that creature from the Black Lagoon, though. If you're painting lots of models at one time, contrast paints are probably worth the price because they could save you a lot of time. Newer painters can save some money because you don't need to base coat and wash. One warning, although I didn't try it, I would be skeptical regarding the color red. In my experience, red is the trickiest color and will only look right if you start with brown, move up to crimson, and highlight with bright red. This is how I painted Dracula's cape here. For tips on painting red, check out my cleric painting video. The link is at the end of this one. For more great tips on crafting and dungeon mastering, check out these videos over here. If you like this video, please like it and share it on social media. For more James Wappel, I'll include a link to his channel below, and I encourage you to check out his series, The Painting Pyramid. It has helped us become way better at painting. Once again, for Dungeon Craft, this is Professor Dungeon Master. Thanks for watching. I'll see you at the table, and may all your rolls be natural 20s.